Happy day, students. Today we are going to learn about whole numbers. Let's see some important terms in this chapter. The first term which we are going to learn about is natural numbers, but you all must be very much familiar with this term. Natural numbers are nothing but all the counting numbers starting from 1. Okay? What are whole numbers? Whole numbers are nothing but all the natural numbers along with 0. So whole numbers starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. What is a successor of a whole number, children? When we add 1 to a whole number, the number which we get as the final result is the successor of that number. Okay, with an example, if you see, here I need to find the successor of 124. What will be the successor? That is the number which comes right after 124 is 125. So 125 is the successor of 124. What is the predecessor of a whole number? It's just quite the opposite of successor. Predecessor of a whole number is the number which comes before the whole number. Here the given whole number is 21, and what comes just before 21? It is 20. Okay, children? So predecessor is nothing but 1 less than the given number, or you can also say the number which comes before the given number. Operations on whole number. We are going to learn about the various operations on whole numbers such as addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So first let's learn about the addition of whole numbers, and before that we will learn about the properties of addition of whole numbers. The first property is closure property. What is a closure property? When A is a whole number and B is a whole number, then the sum of A and B is also a whole number. With an example, let's see this. 9 is a whole number, 20 is a whole number. When I add 9 and 20, my final answer 29 is also a whole number. This is the closure property. Commutative property. Commutative property is when I add in a particular order, and if I change the order, the answer is going to be same. Let's see with an example. I am adding 9 plus 20. Okay. When I add 9 plus 20, I get the answer as 29. Similarly, when I change the order and I add it as 20 plus 9, still my answer is going to be same. This is known as commutative property. Additive property of 0. When a given number is a whole number and you add it with 0, you get the same whole number as your answer. Okay, for example, 9 is a whole number. Okay, when I add it with 0, my answer is going to be 9 only. Okay, there won't be any change. The last law is associative law, and it is very helpful in case of adding bigger numbers. Okay, when we add 2 or more number, this law is very useful. Let's see what this law says. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Now if we see here, only the grouping has been changed. Here A and B is grouped together. Here B and C is grouped together. Okay, so we have to prove that either way the answer is going to be same. Let's take A as 2, B as 4, C as 3. So I am placing it in the same formula, and my left hand side and my right hand side, I get my similar answer. There will not be any change. Okay, now how do we use this law? We use this law when we add bigger number. Okay, we can regroup them and then we can make the addition much easier. For example, I have this number. I have to add 246 plus 300 plus 254. Here I am going to use associative law. How I'm going to use? I am first grouping, okay, a convenient two number. I'm grouping 246 and 254 because when I add them, I will get 500. So I am grouping those two together and I'm keeping 300 separate. So when I add these two first, I get 500. Then I will add 300. This makes my addition much easier. This is where we use this particular law to regroup, rearrange to our convenience and get the answer in an easy manner. Properties of subtraction of whole numbers. Let's see what the property says. A minus B, okay, will be a whole number whenever A is greater than B or A is equal to B. Let's see the example. Here, 9 is A and 5 is B. So clearly here, A is greater than B. So my answer 4 is going to be a whole number. Okay. Similarly, when A is equal to A, when 9 is equal to 9, my answer is 0. 0 is also a whole number. Okay. The next property states that when A and B are whole number, A minus B can never be equal to B minus A. Now, 9 minus 5 is not equal to 5 minus 9. It gives a total different answer. The third property states that when A and B are whole numbers, then A minus 0 is equal to A, but 0 minus A is not equal to a whole number. Whole number starts from 0. Okay, anything less than that does not fall under whole number. So here, according to the statement, when I subtract 0 from 9, when I do 9 minus 0, my answer is 9, which is a whole number. But 0 minus 9 is equal to minus 9, which is clearly not a whole number. Let us see the fourth property of subtraction, children. Here we have grouped just like how we grouped in our addition property. But in addition property, either way when you group them, they are equal. The left hand side of the equation will be equal to the right hand side of the equation. But in subtraction, it is not equal. So let's see with an example. A, B, C are whole numbers. Okay. That is, A I have taken as 9, B I have taken as 3, and C I have taken as 4. First, let's substitute the values in the left hand side. So when I substitute 9 in place of A, 3 in place of B, and then 4 in place of C, I am able to subtract 9 minus 3 and I'm getting my answer as 6. And outside the bracket, I have minus 4. So it becomes 6 minus 4. So my final answer is 2 on the left hand side of the equation. Let's consider the right hand side of the equation. Here I am placing the values of A, B and C just according to the given equation here. Okay. So it is 9 minus B minus C is grouped together. So I've put 3 minus 4. Now, when we see this, it is very clear 3 minus 4 is not a whole number. It is a minus 1 value. So, we know very clearly from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, they are all whole number. Here, we are getting a value minus 1. So, clearly, left hand side is not equal to the right hand side. The fifth property states that A minus B is equal to C, and if this is the condition, B plus C will be equal to A. Okay, considering A, B, C, all three are whole numbers. So let us see this with an example, children. So I am taking A as 9, B as 3. Okay, so A minus B, let's see what I get. When I do a minus b, that is 9 minus 3, I am getting the answer as 6. Okay, so here when I do a minus b, my answer I'm getting as 6. Similarly, let's with the same values try b plus c. So b is nothing but 3. And see what we got? 6. And when I add them both, what I'm getting? I'm getting my a value. So this property is also proved. So whenever we do a minus b to get c, we can also do b plus c to get a. Okay, that is the property. Properties of multiplication of whole numbers. The first property is closure property. When a is a whole number, b is a whole number, then the product of a and b will also be a whole number. Let us see the proof with an example. Here, 9 is a whole number and we know 20 is also a whole number. So the product of 9 and 20 will also be a whole number. So the product of 9 and 20 is 180, and we know very clearly that 180 is a whole number. Next, let's see the commutative property. If a and b are whole numbers, then a multiplied by b will be equal to b multiplied by a. That is, even if you rearrange the order of multiplication, the answer is going to be same. 20 multiplied by 9 is equal to 180. 9 multiplied by 20 will also be 180. There's not going to be any change. So here in this example, 5 multiplied by 4 is also 20, and 4 multiplied by 5 is also 20. Okay. Multiplicative property of 0. When a is a whole number and you multiply with 0, always the answer will be 0. And 0 is also a whole number. Okay. Here I have shown an example. When 9 is multiplied with 0, the answer is going to be 0. And even if you do 0 multiplied by 9, the answer is going to be 0. Any number multiplied by 0, the answer will be 0 itself. Then we are going to see the multiplicative property of 1. Okay. For any whole number A, okay, when we multiply it with 1, we get that whole number itself as the answer. This we all know very well. No matter what the number is, when you multiply it with 1, the answer is that given number. Here I have taken the example A, the whole number as 9. So when I multiply 9 with 1, my answer is going to be 9 only. Associative law of multiplication. What does this law state, children? That is, when 3 or more numbers are multiplied, then their product is the same regardless of how it is being grouped. Here it is grouped in one way and then here it is grouped in a different way. Now, regardless of how it is grouped, when you multiply all of them, your answer on the left hand side and the right hand side is going to be equal. Okay, let us see the distributive law of multiplication over addition. Alright, what does this state? It states that multiplying an entire sum by a number gives the same result as multiplying each addend and then adding their products together. Okay. So that is what we have explained here with an example. We have considered A as 5, B as 2 and C as 4. On the left hand side of the equation, it is being substituted and we've got the answer as 30. And on the right hand side of the equation, also it has been substituted, and when I add the product, still the answer is 30. So the left hand side is equal to the right hand side, hence proved. Distributive law of multiplication over subtraction. Now what is this? This is similar to the above operation with addition. But only thing is here the property is done with the subtraction, with the same rules. Okay, same rules as above, but here the operation which we do is subtraction instead of addition. Okay children, still the left hand side is equal to the right hand side when we substitute with the values of ABC, given that ABC is a whole number. Division in whole numbers. What is division itself, children? Division means it's an inverse operation of multiplication. Here I am dividing A by B, and my answer which I am getting when I divide A by B is C. This can also be written by B multiplied by C is equal to A. Okay, this is how I explain division as an inverse operation of a multiplication. This remains the concept of the entire division algorithm. What is division algorithm? Division algorithm is a formula, okay, through which we can find out if our division is done correctly or not. Okay, let's see how it's been done. Now we divide the dividend by a divisor in order to get our quotient. Okay, so here I have divided 162, which is my dividend. I'm dividing it by my divisor 3. After dividing, the quotient which I've got is 54 and the remainder is 0. Now I want to check if my division is done correctly. So what is the formula, children? The dividend is nothing but the divisor multiplied by the quotient plus the 0. So let's find out. Dividend is equal to, the divisor is 3, the quotient I've got is 54, plus the remainder is 0. So 3 multiplied by 54 is 162, plus the remainder 0, so the answer is 162. So here we know our dividend is also 162. So the division is done correctly. We have checked it through the division algorithm. Okay children, now let's see the properties of division of whole numbers, children. The first property states that A divided by B is not always a whole number. Okay, now consider A to be 11 and B to be 2. Okay, when I divide 11 by 2, it does not divide 11 equally. Okay, I get a remainder. So obviously my answer will be in decimal. When the value is in decimal number, it is clearly not a whole number. So that is what they have mentioned here. A divided by B is not always a whole number. Okay. Division by 0. Now any number being divided by 0 is actually meaningless. You can't divide any number by 0. It doesn't have any meaning at all. Okay. The third property is, when you divide 0 by a whole number, your answer is always going to be 0. When you divide nothing, then the answer is also going to be nothing only. Okay. For example, when I divide 0 by 3, my answer is 0 only. When I divide 0 by 10, my answer is going to be 0 only. There's not going to be any change. So that's all in this chapter, children. I hope you all understood the concepts clearly. Let's meet you all in the next class. Bye. Thank you.